Merrimack TV is committed to our community. From gavel-to-gavel coverage of town and school board meetings to updates on town services and projects, we aim to keep you connected.
Good morning, I'm Kyle Fox, Public Works Director for the Town of Merrimack.
Hi, I'm Diane Trippett. I'm the Town Clerk Tax Collector for the Town of Merrimack.
I'm Captain Matt Tarleton with the Merrimack, New Hampshire Police Department.
And keep the public informed of every motion.
All those in favor, signify by saying aye. Aye.
And many moments, so you can be confident that we're here for you. Thanks for watching. Stay connected. Follow Merrimack TV on Facebook.
Thank you, Nick. Good evening, everybody. My name is Kyle Fox, Public Works Director, and I'm going to be hosting a rather unusual public information meeting tonight. Like everything, we're doing what we can to keep moving forward and within the means that we have. So we're trying our first Public Works public information meeting virtually. Thank you to our media services staff for their help in putting this together first and foremost. And hopefully this will be successful. The point of tonight's meeting is to discuss the middle school sewer reconstruction project that's going to be upcoming very soon. And we'll run from Babusick Lake Road up Madeline Bennett Road to the middle school project. Tonight's meeting, I'm going to talk about the history of the project. I'm going to go over where we are with the current project, what the traffic impacts will be. I'll talk a little bit about the schedule of the project, talk about the sewer connections for the residences next to the sewer, talk about a little bit about the drainage in the area, and finally, we'll open it up for questions. The question portion of the program is really important, and really the biggest reason for this meeting is to engage with the public, hear what your questions and concerns are about the project, so we can do the best job we can to provide the town with a quality project done in a professional manner and with as little interruption to the abutters and the folks who normally travel through the project that we can. So first, a little history on the project. The sewer line that we're talking about was originally constructed as part of the middle school construction that occurred back in 2004-2005 timeframe. The sewer line that was constructed at that point was designed in accordance with the town's sewer master plan, which meant that it had to be very deep, which is a difficult installation. The reason for the deepness of the sewer is for future connectivity to other parts of the town. After the completion of the work, it was noticed that there were defects in the construction, and that caused the Public Works Department and the town to not formally accept the sewer. And to date, the town has not accepted that sewer. It is considered a private sewer of the school at this point only. Some time ago, a developer who owned a large piece of land above the middle school, kind of between the middle school and Old Blood Road, came up with a concept for a subdivision project that they wanted to have sewer to connect to. The developer proposed so as part of that subdivision, the developer would be required in order to do a cluster subdivision to connect to the sewer. The problem is they can't connect to a sewer that's not been accepted by the town. So the developer came up with the concept to ask for 6 additional lots from what would normally be allowed in order to pay for the the cost to fix that sewer. So the developer went in front of the zoning board and the planning board, and this is many years ago, and both boards approved that concept, ultimately resulting in an approved plan set. Recently, that process occurred again as costs have risen and the developer has had issues with funding the project. They were granted some additional lots by both the zoning board and the planning board. So now the developer was ready to move forward with the project. At that point, the developer and the town council came to an agreement that would have the developer pay for the project by giving money to the town, and the town would manage the project. And so that leads us up to about where we are today with the money has been given to the town to the tune of $1.2 million, and Public Works is now managing the project. So what is the project? We will be reconstructing about 1,000 feet of sewer line that runs on Babusick Lake Road between Jessica Drive and McQuestion Road. The sewer will be relocated. It currently resides in the eastbound travel lane. The contractor is going to install a new parallel sewer line that'll be at the center line of the road, and the existing sewer will be disbanded. So the nice thing for motorcycles and vehicles, the manhole covers will no longer be in the center of the travel lane. They'll be at the center of the road. Additionally, there's one section of the sewer run that's on Madeline Bennett Road itself that also needs some work to be done. That work is lesser in scope and won't require as much effort to accomplish. Before getting into the big details of the how the project will go, I wanted to talk a little bit about the traffic impacts, because that's going to be a big impact for the project and for the abutters who live next to the project. So Babusick Lake Road between McQuestion and Jessica will be closed for about 3 months for this project. In order to accomplish the work that needs to be done, with the sewer being 20 feet plus deep in the ground, the contractor is going to take up most of the roadway to be able to do that, to where it will be impossible to leave any full lanes open for traffic to go through. So the contractor will be setting up a detour and will be focusing traffic to utilize Turkey Hill Road to McQuestion Road as the detour. Access for residents, of course, will be maintained at all times unless not physically practical at that very moment. When those times occur, the contractor will be in touch with each resident affected to discuss prior to the work taking place. I do want to make note that specifically emergency vehicles, fuel deliveries, mail services, and other things of that nature will be allowed to occur throughout the project. There just may be delays, obviously not for emergency vehicles, but for the other things. And other arrangements may be made on a temporary basis, such as relocating mailboxes for a short period of time, but they would be put back to their original location at the end of the project. For the Madeline Bennett Lane portion of the work, we're lucky that road is 36 feet wide as opposed to our normal 24-foot road. So we will actually be able to leave one lane open for alternating one-way traffic during that work. So Madeline Bennett Lane, which is a dead-end road, will be open to at least one lane of traffic at all times. The schedule for the work, those of you who live next to the project will note that a lot of activity has already started taking place. The real work starts tomorrow, and the very first phase of the project is to install many wells to dewater the ground to a depth of about 25 feet. What that does is when the contractor excavates for the sewer pipe, it'll keep the trench dry so that they can lay the pipe in at the slope that they need it and without the defects that occurred the last time the installation was done back in 2004, 2005. So that the work to install all of those little wells, which are going to be about every 7.5 feet along the north side of Busick Lake Road, that work is going to start tomorrow. We expect it to take about until the end of May for the subcontractor to get all of the dewatering system in place and functioning. Once that's up and running, the actual sewer line replacement will begin. We expect that to happen around June 1st. It's going to be a very slow process because of the depth of the work and contractor needing to utilize trench boxes and move at a pace that's safe. They expect to do about 20 feet of pipe a day, which doesn't sound like a lot, but they'll be working full days and working as quickly and safely as they can. That June 1st date, or thereabouts when they start the sewer work, is when the road will actually be shut down to traffic. Once the excavator gets out in the middle of the road, there won't be any way for us to maintain traffic through the work zone, except for local traffic, as mentioned previously. The sewer line, the main sewer line work is expected to take about 2 months. And so that'll take us through most of June and July. Once the main sewer line run is done, we will begin doing the service ties to each of the properties. And what that means is they'll be connecting a side pipe from the sewer main that was just installed to each of the properties. And that side pipe will be taken all the way from the center of Babusick Lake Road to the property line on each side of the road. And we'll talk more about connecting to the sewer in a bit. We expect that to take about 2 weeks to put all the services to each of the properties in. Then the contractor will begin reconstructing the road and repaving the road. The final step of the project will be to do the roadside cleanup and do the yard restorations, loaming everything back in, making everybody's property back to the way it was before the project started. And we expect the entire project to be done by September 4th, open to traffic. Next, talking a little bit about the sewer connections. Connection to an accepted town sewer line is required by both state law and the Merrimack Town Code if a building is located within 200 feet of the sewer line. So this will apply to all of the houses, I believe, that are on Babusick Lake Road and a couple that are on Merry Meeting Drive, but that their backyard abuts onto Madeline Bennett Lane, where the sewer is as well. Those outside of the 200 feet limit aren't required to connect up, but if they want to, people can still connect it, as long as the grades and elevations work. And we can work with any abutter who would like to do so. In order to make the connections as easy as possible, one thing I'll be doing very soon is sending out to each of the abutters a picture of your property with your approximate property lines from our GIS system and your building on it. And what I'm going to ask is that each abutter draw on that map where their existing sewer pipe exits their foundation out to their septic system. I would also ask that they put on that piece of paper, if they have a preference, where they want the sewer tie-in from the road to come in. If you're trying to avoid a swimming pool or a shed, a driveway, any other feature on your property, a tree, and that can be accomplished. And now is the best time to let us know those kind of details, because we can put the service connection to the property any place we want at this point. But once they're installed in the ground, we cannot change it. So that'll be the biggest piece of communication we'll be looking for to guide us in helping this project to be successful for the abutters to the project. The cost to connect to the sewer has three components. There's a $2,000 connection fee that gets paid to the Wastewater Division of Public Works, a $50 sewer connection inspection fee for the building department, and that covers the cost of the building inspector to come out and inspect the connection of the sewer into the actual house. And then finally is the actual construction of the sewer line from the property line to the house. Now that will be done by a private contractor hired by each resident. While we can't recommend any specific contractor or group of contractors, when we do these kind of projects, I do always recommend that homeowners team up with your neighbors to obtain quotes for doing more than one connection, as by grouping up, you might get better pricing than if you each seek different contractors on your own. Finally, just a little bit about the drainage in the area, specifically the Babusick Lake Road portion on the north side of the road where most of the houses are. We know there's some drainage issues, puddles that occur. The biggest one is at the intersection of Maidstone Drive and Babusick Lake Road. Every time it rains there's quite a puddle. And it's a project that's been on our drainage master plan for quite some time. Now that we have a contractor there doing some work, we are for certain going to connect that intersection across to the Jessica Drive drainage system to eliminate that puddle. We're also going to do some research to see if it's possible to add drainage along the north side of Babusick Lake Road to take care of some of those problems. Currently, there's three or four leaching catch basins that were installed many years ago that have limited effectiveness in taking care of rainstorm issues for the neighbors because they don't have any pipes connecting them. So they basically, once they fill up during a rainstorm, they don't take any more until it leaches back into the ground. With that, I see we have a couple people that have joined us for the meeting. We can open it up to any questions or comments you have on the project. Thank you.
Kyle, they'll want to press *9 to be recognized.
Okay. Thank you, Nick. Anyone who wants to speak, please press *9 to be recognized. And we can call out the last three digits of your phone number to make sure that the right person is speaking. So right now, the person ending in 059, please go ahead.
Hey, Kyle, I think I was talking to you the other morning. I was on my front steps when you were taking the water samples.
Yes.
Yeah, so I forgot to mention to you that morning about the drainage problem. From the driveway, we had it all paved a year ago. The drainage problem was horrendous. There was no drain here at all to catch the water. It was practically just about going into the driveway, into the garage. So when we raised the driveway to pitch everything towards Bob Nolette's area at 167, there's a drainage over there, but the grades are off. It really needs a drain at the side of the driveway to go into that drain. So I don't know how, if it can be rectified. At the same time, to put a drain over there on the edge of the driveway. In the wintertime, it's real bad because now the ground's all frozen. The water has nowhere to go. There's a lot of water that comes off the road into the driveway.
Right. Great question, and thanks for asking it. I did also speak with your neighbor that you just mentioned, earlier Bob, today yeah. as well. So coming into this project, we don't have money budgeted for drainage on this stretch of road at this time. That's not to say we can't try and move money around from other projects that are not being done this year. As I mentioned a few minutes ago, we're definitely going to accomplish the issue with Mainstone Drive, Babusick Lake intersection, because that's by far the worst area along that stretch. The difficulty with putting drainage in there is, unfortunately, the Merrimack Village District water main is located exactly at the edge of the pavement, which is where we would put our drainage system. So what we'll have to do is we'll work with each of the neighbors to see if we can kind of put a system back away from the road where those existing leaching bases are. We'll kind of come up with a schematic to see what can work, and then we'll get a price from our contractor and see if we can't organize the funds to make it happen while everything else is going on.
Okay, it's because of the road so high, it just feeds all that water this way.
Right, and but even if the road was lower, there's still nowhere for the water to go. Unless we put in an actual closed drainage system. So that's what we're going to try to accomplish. One of the things I should have mentioned during the presentation is we've had a surveyor shoot the existing grade of both the existing sewer system and the road. And when we put everything back together, the road will not be any higher than it is today. It'll be at the same elevation or even a little bit lower than it is today, because we don't want to create additional drainage problems.
Right. So this drainage issue will be rectified after the job's completed?
I'll have to work with the contractor to see. And again, it matters if we can pull money together for it as well. That's one of the things that we'll have to work on. We'll have to figure out what it's going to cost to do the system after, you know, working with the abutters to figure out what each individual problem is, because we want to address them all while we're doing something. Then we'll get a price on it, and we'll see if we can find money in the budget to do the project now. That's certainly my preference. As far as timing of the project, the way it would work is that would probably be done certainly after the new sewer line and the sewer stubs are installed, because all of that work has to be done while the dewatering equipment is running, and drainage work would not require the dewatering equipment. So they're going to do the main focus absolutely first, and then if we do the drainage run, it would be towards the end of the project.
Okay. I just didn't know how far along that you guys actually realize how bad it really was here. It's bad here.
We do realize it, and like I said, certainly the Maidstone intersection has been on our drainage master plan for probably 12 or 13 years at least. So we've been waiting for this project to happen to be able to fix that problem. And while we're there, we're going to certainly see if we can do a little bit more.
All right, that'd be great.
Hey, Kyle, this is Nicholas in media. Don't mean to interrupt, but you may want to remind your callers to state their name and address for the record.
Oh, thank you, Nick. Did that reminder just go out to everybody?
Yep.
I'm Rick Valandry at 165 Babusick Lake Road.
Thank you, Rick. Would anyone else like to speak?
Callers will want to press *9 to be recognized.
caller with 059. Is that Rick again?
No, it's Kyle. No, this is Heather Dodds at 165 Abusick.
Oh, hi, Heather. Yes.
Hi, how are you? I just have a question about, I don't know if I missed it. How is the $2,000, like, how is that being charged to us? Is it coming through on a water bill? Is it a one-time bill? Is it split up? What's the, how are we paying that $2,000? Like, how are we getting billed?
Yeah, great question, Heather. So what will happen as we get close to the end of the project, when we're confident of a completion date and we can start letting abutters know that they can connect, we'll send out a notice to everybody letting them know. At that point, the first step in the process is filling out, is contacting our wastewater treatment department. They're part of Public Works, so you can get them through me or calling the wastewater division directly. But you'll request the connection to the system in that manner. We'll send you a sewer connection permit, and that's where you would pay the $2,000 fee. And that's an upfront fee before you do the connection. Once you've paid that fee, that's when you'll want to have your contractor ready to mobilize. So you can do a lot of the pre-work before any of that. If you and your neighbors want to get together and try and either share contractors, which might get you better pricing, or if you have a contractor you love already that you want to utilize, you can come up with that plan ahead of time to be ready to go if you're eager to get connected this year. And then at that point, the only other fee to the town is the $50 building inspection fee. And that's for the building department, the building inspector, to inspect the final connection into the house. And that would be paid at the time of that you switch over from your septic system to the new sewer system. One other thing I should have mentioned, the way the law is written for the sewer connections is there's 180 days leeway allowed for connecting to the system. Generally, what we've done on these types of projects where they're developer projects that abutters didn't necessarily know about or have a lot of advance notice, we generally give a full year to make the connection. And we'll do that in this case as well. We do understand the connection is a big expense, and particularly with everything going on right now, that may be money that's hard for folks to come up with. So in light of that, we certainly would extend the timeline for connection to up to a year from the time we complete the project. So basically by September-ish 2021, we would expect everyone to be connected.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. Good question, thank you. Anyone else would like to speak and go ahead and hit *9. While we're waiting for anyone else who wants to jump in, I would add, throughout the project, we want this to be a really successful project for all of the abutters and for the town, like we do all of our projects. Any questions you have, any concerns, be it with the work that's going on, the workers that are out there, just general questions about the project, please either call Public Works at 424-5137, and you can ask for me. Or you can email me at my email address is kfox@merrimacnh.gov, and I'd be happy to hear from anyone. So Nick, it doesn't look like we have anyone else looking to speak tonight. So I guess I'll wrap up the meeting. Did you want to showcase your video one more time?
If you're going to conclude the public hearing, we'll do just that and just have you stand by for a moment.
Very good. Thank you.
Merrimack TV is committed to our community. From gabble-to-gabble coverage of town and school board meetings to updates on town services and projects, we aim to keep you connected.
Good morning. I'm Kyle Fox, Public Works Director for the town of Merrimack.
Hi, I'm Diane Trippett. I'm the town clerk tax collector for the town of Merrimack.
I'm Captain Matt Tarleton with the Merrimack New Hampshire Police Department.
And keep the public informed of every motion.
All those in favor, signify by saying aye. Aye.
And many moments, so you can be confident that we're here for you. Thanks for watching. Stay connected. Follow Merrimack TV on Facebook.